not getting mad at me. Oh, oh. Sometimes it's hard to face reality.
Don't be afraid to stand alone. Don't be afraid to stand outside your comfort.
Welcome Lion's Den today. Dear viewers, today we're going to delve into a fascinating topic about Ephraim and melanin. Now, Ephraim isn't a term you often come across, but it's actually the name of a unique substance that has a range of practical applications. This substance is derived from the skin or bark of some trees, and it's known for its natural tanning properties. Ephraim is used as a dye to create brown and black shades. It's not just for aesthetic purposes. This substance has been used by indigenous communities for centuries to protect their skin from sun exposure. And today, it's still used in certain countries. In addition to its tanning abilities, Ephraim also has potential health benefits like treating wounds and fungal infections. Now let's shift our focus to melanin. This term refers to the pigment that gives color to our skin, hair, and eyes. It's produced by cells in our body called melanocytes. The presence of melanin determines our skin tone. The more melanin we have, the darker our complexion will be. Interestingly, melanin also plays a role in our eye color too. Melanin is crucial for protecting our skin against sun damage and preventing skin cancer. So if you thought melanin was just about color, think again. It's an essential component of our overall health and well-being. We talked about Ephraim melanin and what type of melanin in different pigments. Skin's Ephraim. It goes to show that nature can provide us with some amazing substances for use in everyday life, whether it's as a natural sunscreen or as a way to protect us against disease. Enthusiasts, into the world of Ephraim and melanin. Ephraim, also known as eumelanin or brown pigment, is a type of melanin that gives our hair and skin their brown color. It's a fascinating molecule that plays a crucial role in the process of photosynthesis in plants. Melanin is a group of pigments found in animals. There are two types, eumelanin brown and pheomelanin red. Eumelanin is responsible for the brown color of our hair and skin, while pheomelanin gives us that beautiful red color we associate with ginger hair. So next time you see someone with that stunning red hair or admire the lush green leaves on a tree, remember it's all thanks to these amazing molecules, Ephraim and melanin. Thanks for joining me in this exploration of the science behind our hair and skin color. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit like, share, and subscribe for more exciting science content. Until next time, stay curious and keep learning. And that wraps up today's video on Ephraim and melanin.